Hey guys, thanks for tuning in. So today we got something really cool. This is the HENG German Tiger 1/16 scale airsoft RC tank. Now I've been wanting to review something like this for a while and I got one in. So this one's cool because it does shoot airsoft BBs. It's got smoke that, it's got a little smoke function where it kind of simulates the exhaust of the tank while it's running. It's got sound, it's got motions, it's got firing motions and all kinds of stuff. So with this review, we are going to do a full unbox, inspection, setup, and also go ahead and do some running on this. And within this review, I'm going to do something a little bit extra on this one. I'm going to go ahead and install this little FPV camera on here. It's just a 5.8 gigahertz little micro camera. And I'm just going to put a little battery on this. You can connect like a 5 volt, up to 5 volt battery on this cam. I'm going to put it on the tank, and then I'm going to go ahead and, part of the driving test, I'm going to go ahead and record the video in these Commander version 1 goggles. So I'm really liking these goggles right now. They've got a great feature where they can scan for channels, and also they have the DVR inside. So I am really loving these. And so what we'll be doing is we'll be doing like a line of sight drive test off of my, hat cam. And also I'll be throwing these on in part of the review and showing you how it looks FPV and driving around and trying to shoot some targets while we have the FPV on and record all that for you. Okay, so I'm just going to flip around the box just a little bit so you can kind of see what the graphics look like on the box. You can see it's got real smoke, so it's got one of those little smoke generators on there that you have some smoke oil to make some simulated smoke. It's got suspension, it's got the airsoft cannon in there, which they give you BBs for. It's got lights, it's got movements of the barrel up and down. You can also move the barrel side to side. Top of the tank, you can go forward, back, of course, and then it's also got real sound. So I'm really anxious to check this thing out. And the cool thing about this one is these guys really go in depth on all the stuff in here. So here's the controller side, and then what's cool also is look at this. They give you a full-on breakdown, and it's got all these. It's like a full breakdown of the tank, and this is actually the real tank breakdown. It's telling you what all these things are in the real life tank. You know what I mean? It's not going to have all these things in this tank, but it's giving you kind of the history of how this tank functions and operates and everything involved. It's giving you a little history here on the side. So pretty darn awesome. Now, there's also, if you look at this side of the box, there's also a upgradable like metal component version. So if you really wanted to get into this thing, you can spend the extra money and you can get a metal drive gearbox. You can upgrade the motors as well. I saw some upgrades online. This is just the base version, but you can also put in metal tracks. This one now has like plastic rubber tracks. And then you can upgrade the metal drive wheels there for the tracks. All kinds of stuff. So you can see how this is the alloy version and that's the steel version. So you have all different kinds of upgrades you can do for the drivetrain, and that's pretty darn cool. Anyways, let's go ahead and take this thing out of the box and see how it looks. Okay, so I want to make sure I'm kind of pulling this thing out in the right direction. That looks like the right way. Wow, so you can see how it's kind of a larger tank, that's for sure. There it is. Look at that thing. Cool. So right off the bat, what fell out of the box also are these accessories. So it looks like, steel simulated cables and accessories here. And then here's the instruction book with some target material here. Anyway, moving on, we've got this little protective bag on the barrel. It looks like we have a protective little thing here for the top there. I'm just going to start pulling everything out of the box. I guess I should start with the tank. So we'll just pull this out sideways, it looks like. Set that down here, and we'll look at that in depth in just a second. Here's the controller. Looks like here's some more accessories in this box here. Here's a charger. So it looks like I did get the Euro charger. So I'll have to have an adapter for that. And then it looks like a little airsoft package with some airsoft pellets in there. Okay, cool. So this is everything you get in the box. Tank, charger, some airsoft BBs, this accessory pack, and the controller, and that's everything in the box. So we have one bag in here, and let's see what we get. It's just a taped bag. I'm seeing some stickers and decals for the tank, so if you want to make it look more realistic, put those on. Look at this. Wow. So we have these shovels and stuff, all this stuff to kind of simulate the realism of the tank. You can see how you just pop these out, and it looks like we can just pop them in or glue them onto the tank. So I'll definitely be doing that before we drive it. This looks like a little antenna we're going to put on for the 2.4 control frequency. Let's just take everything out of this bag. There's a lot of little parts in here, so you're definitely going to want to be careful. And it looks like these guys are just things that we're going to be putting on the tank. You know what I mean? Like little accessories. There's a bunch of stuff in here. These look like these are the sticks for the controller. So the controller here has the sticks off, so we're just going to push those in. Looks like they push in really tight. I guess you could glue them in if you wanted to, but they're pushing in super tight, and they don't feel like they're going to pull out unless you really give them some pressure. But I'd recommend maybe just super gluing those in, just to make them stay in there so you never lose them. Anyway, we got the driver here. So this is the guy you're gonna put like on the top of the tank for realism, you know? His arms actually move, wow. So you can position them there on the top of the tank if you wanted to. And then just a bunch of bags with all these little things like extra tank tracks, actually. That's extra plastic tank tracks. If you break some tank tracks. Here's some panels we're gonna be putting on. You know, here's some, looks like some chain hitches and chain links that we're going to be putting on there, some U-bolts. It's even got like a little, wow, it's even got a little headphones thing, well, a little earmuffs for the driver. So you can put those on and those come separate. So they're going into quite a bit of detail here, extra tank attachments. Here's some double-sided sticky tape, probably how you're going to go ahead and attach the driver with this double-sided sticky tape here. So very impressed so far with all the detail they're going in and all the extra little parts we're getting. You know, this is not a super expensive tank, and for companies to give all these extra things in the package is really commendable. So far, I'm pretty impressed. So here we've got a box of BBs. So it looks like there's like two bags of these BBs in here. And I guess, what is that, like maybe 200 BBs? Looks like maybe 100 BBs per bag, and they give you two bags. So we're gonna load that up in the tank before we go ahead and drive it, and so we can shoot airsoft BBs. And here's the remote controller. So a great little remote controller, and it looks like it's got like all these functions here. We can see that we can turn off and on the smoke. We've got volume for the sound effects on the tank. And then we've got, we can switch our sound effects mode, and then lock. So this probably maybe starts up the tank. And then we've got this thing here. I'm not sure if that does anything. These other trim tabs are just completely stuck. They don't do anything. This is the only one that moves here. And then we have our control here. We've got bullet shooting, and we've got machine gun sound. Anyway, this thing's got quite a bit of features. You know, you can move around and drive around, move the turret up and down, left and right, and I'll go through all that in just a second. We'll go ahead and put the battery in and see how it looks. Now for the main event, here we are. Here's the German Tiger One. So check this out. So it's got the full barrel here, and this is a shooting barrel. So this thing will shoot airsoft coming out of the barrel. It looks like right here is we're gonna push on that 2.4 gigahertz antenna for better range. So it looks like just a push on little thing. And look at the detail of this thing. It looks pretty good. Here's the suspension of the wheels. You can see how they all have their own little suspension here. And then here's the drive wheels. The motor's gonna be in this front wheel, and then everything else just kinda rotates along with the track. Now these are just plastic tracks. Like I mentioned before, you can upgrade this to metal tracks and these metal guys here. I think you can also upgrade these to metal as well if you wanted to. But just look at the detail on this thing. This thing is very nicely detailed. I'm seeing a lot of attention to detail here. Spinning it around, looks like there's LED lights here. There's one there, one on the other side, a little machine gun down there. And of course, I don't have anything attached, so you saw all those accessories. So you'll see all those accessories attached in just a moment here when I start to drive it. Here's where the smoke's gonna come out. And you know what? That brings me to the smoke oil. I didn't see any smoke oil in this kit, so maybe they forgot to put it in there. So a little con out of the box, you know, manufacturer should check, make sure they have that smoke oil in there. But I believe if you look closely in this one, I think I caught that a little while ago. You see those tubes in there? So there's just those plastic, there's a plastic tube there, and there's a plastic tube on that side. And so this thing is just like a pump with a smoke generator that is gonna just pump out some smoke coming out the back. I'm not sure, maybe it's an international shipping thing where they can't put oil in the package, but I'll definitely be getting some oil and trying that. If I'm not able to get the oil in this review, I'll do a review where I upgrade all the components to metal so you guys can see how all that looks and how the upgrade works. So taking off this little hatch on the top, looks like it is having like a little bit of a plastic guard there. And here is the hatch. So I think, you know what, this is where you put in the Airsoft BBs. So you just put in the Airsoft BBs in there, and then you can put the hatch back on. And this is where you're gonna kind of sticky tape your driver to the top. So if you do wanna put your driver in, you see how this thing opens up? So that's pretty cool, pretty realistic. Everything is working with hinges and stuff. And then we have this other hatch over here. And the funny thing is, I looked at the instructions before I opened this up. And this is actually, it's supposed to be a switch. It says in the instructions, but there's no switch in here. It's a switch to shoot the barrel, to turn off and on the airsoft barrel. And it seems like it's already on because I went ahead and briefly tested it. So nothing really happening with this hatch. You know what I mean? So just leave that shut. But cool detail anyway, it does open up and close. And in the back, you can see that it does have a big speaker back here. So this is gonna give you the sound effects. You can kind of see it glistening, the driver in the bottom there underneath. So that's a kind of a large speaker. Couple inches of full range speaker in there. And then look at this simulated piping and tubing. It's done very well. Of course, nothing's actually flowing through here. It's flowing through these little plastic tubes for the smoke down there. And then just further checking this thing out, it's looking very good. You know, tracks are working really smooth. I'm just kind of rotating it with my hand so you can kind of see how the tracks are gonna move and the suspension moves. Cool, so I'm really anxious to get this thing going. Anyway, going ahead and checking out the front, look at that. So we have a little simulated extra track there on the front there, clipped in. So this is just for simulation. They do give us the extra tracks, these tracks in the package, so we won't be using this. This is just for looks. Flipping the thing over, this is where we're gonna be accessing our battery bay. So if we go ahead and zoom in here to the battery bay, we're seeing that it's got like this little push lock mechanism. So this is spring loaded coming out here, and then we're just gonna grab this door and pull it open, and the door doesn't like swing, it just kind of falls off. And here's our little battery. It is a 7.4 volt 1800 lithium ion, so it's not a lithium polymer, it's the harder lithium ion. And let's see how we go ahead and tuck this thing. It looks like it'll tuck in just like that, perfect like that. And there's only one way this thing can go on. Just like this, pull back again and pop open that, pop close that spring-loaded thing there, and we're all set to go. On-off switch, so turning that switch there on, and I'm seeing the front lights flash. Let me back this up a little. See those front lights flash there? So that means we're on and ready to go. All we need to do is go ahead and put batteries in this controller, and this uses 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 AA batteries. So let me go ahead and put some batteries in there real quick. All right, cool. So 6 AA batteries in the controller. Wow. There we go. Looks like maybe this little door got kind of broken shipping. So one of the clips is kind of off. Anyway, that thing sounds pretty awesome. There's the barrel movement. Look at that. If I'm pushing up on the barrel here, you see it rising, lowering. So not a whole lot of movement on up and down. That's the extent of that. Here's the barrel. Let's see what the extent is on the top. So it can almost go all the way around 360. Go all the way around the other way. Yeah, that's the extent of the other way there. And it looks like we can We can move it up and down so we can do multiple channels at the same time. That's pretty awesome. Just a real quick side to side movement. So the right stick, left. See that? Right stick, right. Wow, this thing's really looking good. I can go pretty slow too if I just barely touch the stick. You see how it's going slower? Forward. Whoa. So a little tough to go super slow going forward and back, but not too bad for a toy, you know? So it's looking really good. I'm not gonna be able to have any smoke right now because I don't have any smoke oil. But if I just get some of that, it should work fine, I hope. Anyway, let's try to just shoot this thing without any airsoft BBs in it and see what happens. I think we hold the right. Wow, there we go. So all we're doing is we're holding the fire button and then we're pushing up on the barrel rise. And you can really hear it. It's got movement, it's got sound effects, and it should be shooting an airsoft if the airsoft is loaded in there. I don't have any loaded up right now. But this thing is really nice. What else can we do? Can we change the volume here? Yeah, so it's getting, there's volume off. That was pretty loud for the mic probably, but there's volume off. Volume low, medium, and high. Yeah, so we have all different kinds of volume selections there. So pretty neat. And then if we want to switch the sound, let's see. We have different sounds. Oh, there's a machine gun. Okay, so machine gun's here. And I can see a little LED light. You see that little LED light there lighting up? Well, that's pretty cool. That's that machine gun. We should be able to change the sound on this. Okay, so I just pressed both of these buttons in at the same time, and you can hear it's got different sounds now. So now it's different sound effects for everything. You see how it all sounds a little different? Whoa. So that's way cool. Yeah, it's got a completely different set of sounds. Awesome, guys. So let's see if we go ahead and press the lock button again. Nice, so that's basically a turning off the engine sound. Cool, so let me go ahead and put all this stuff, these stickers and all these effects on the tank. I'm gonna go ahead and fill this thing with some airsoft BBs. Why don't we just fill the thing with some airsoft BBs right now, just so you guys can see how it's actually done. Just going ahead and popping up this guy and then taking out a bag of airsoft BBs. Open it up, it's just got a little bag here, and fill this thing up. And that's all you're doing is filling up the top of the hatch and just making sure those BBs, that's one full bag. Let me go ahead and take this off and we can kind of see how they're going in there. Shake it a little bit and all those BBs fell in that little hole. You see that there? So we don't have to worry about, you know, jamming the thing up. It looks like maybe one bag is enough for a load there. Cool. Cool, guys, so far so good. Just that little missing liquid smoke in there and one slightly broken hinge on this hatch here. Just like one side is a little bit off, but that's minor, nothing major. So let me go ahead and charge this thing up and let's drive this thing. Okay, guys, let's give the Hang Long German Tiger 1 tank a thorough running test. As you can see, I got all the stickers on here. We got the crosses, the number. I got all these guys on here. I'll have had that little sped up video of me putting everything together, but pretty detailed, you know. You get the driver here, or I don't know if it's the driver, but it's the spotter guy up here. And as you can see, I went ahead and mounted this little FPV camera like I was saying I was going to do. And I just kind of double-sided sticky taped it to the barrel and put some rubber bands over it. Made a little adapter to plug in this kind of battery here. And this is just a little 1S battery. So I'm going to be running it kind of line of sight, and then we'll go ahead and throw on the these Amways, these guys here. These are the Amway Commander goggles I'm really liking. And these have a built-in DVR, so I'll be recording this in just a sec. So you guys can kind of see what I'm seeing in the FPV, and we'll try to do some like shooting from FPV, and I might go try to go out of the yard here and go into the street and see what kind of terrain we can get over. I want to go through different types of terrain. I want to go through some dirt, I want to go through some grass here, and I also want to kind of go over some logs and just kind of see how it handles. I did have one instance where I was turning in the longer grass and one of the tracks kind of came off, so we'll see if we can possibly replicate that. You know, it seems like these plastic tracks they're a little bit loose, so maybe you could take out a link and kind of tighten them up. But let's go ahead and get this thing fired up and see how it does. Okay, so with this guy, as soon as you power on the tank, you see the flashing front lights, and then you turn on the controller, and it's basically automatically bound, and all you have to do is press the unlock key here. Killer little startup sound. I want to make sure the volume is pretty loud so you guys can hear this. Let's go ahead and drive around. First, we'll go ahead and go over some wood here. Let's see what it can handle. So this is just a regular 2x4, a little bit larger log than a large log. And I haven't tested this yet, so we're just gonna kind of go ahead and really see what it's all about. So I'm gonna kind of go slow at first. No problem with that first log there. Let me get the barrel up a little bit. There we go. Second log. A little bit of a problem, but it still is able to make it over. And I doubt it's gonna be able to make it over this log, but we'll go ahead and try. Might have to hit it at like a different angle. Almost. There we go. Wow, so it might do it with some speed actually. Oh, almost. I'm kind of hearing the tracks are starting to strip a little, giving it too much power. But you can see how it's, you know, it's pretty solid. Looks like nothing's breaking yet. There's that articulation on the wheels there. But pretty darn cool. I'm gonna go ahead and blast through it here and see how it can handle everything. Full throttle. Nice. Okay, don't want to break it yet before I finish the review. So pretty neat. As you can see, the barrel moving around and stuff like I showed you in the living room. And the sound effects are pretty awesome. I'm gonna go ahead and shoot at the other camera real quick. I don't want to shoot it, but I'll go ahead and shoot at it. Maybe you'll be able to see that pellet get close to it. Cool. All right, so there's a little test there. Let's go ahead and slap on the FPV and drive this thing around in just a second. I want you to hear this cool acceleration sound it has. Like when you reach a certain speed, it actually has like a full throttle transition. Let's see if we can hear that. You hear how it has that high revving throttle? Now we can go ahead and do like a slow turn while we're going forward. And it actually does pretty good. What you don't want to really do in the grass is give it like a full turn like this, or the tracks seem to possibly come off in this longer grass. So if you're gonna turn in grass like this, get some, keep some forward momentum, and then turn like that. But it does pretty good. As you can see, it's negotiating the terrain here pretty good. Not bad at all. You know, it has its limitations, but pretty darn neat. It's more like a simulation tank with extra functions, so seems to be doing pretty darn good. Let's get a shot of the barrel here turning and firing. So it has that reaction shot, the recoil that goes backwards. So if you're sideways, it's not going to be super accurate because it's meant to be shooting forward and showing that recoil. So if you hold the right top button and push up on the left stick, pretty cool. Sound effects and everything sound great. All right. Well, you know what I want to do? I want to slap on these FPV goggles and let's get out there and drive around the yard and see how far we can get with the FPV goggles, and I'll go ahead and record that for you guys to see. Let's do it. Okay guys, so these goggles are great because you can just scan for the channel, whatever channel your FPV's at, as long as there's nobody else around you, you'll pick up the strongest channel. So as you can see, I went ahead and put this battery, I just have it kind of pushed on with double-sided sticky tape, so you know nothing's gonna fly off. I'm just gonna kind of push it on hard for this one. Then all we're doing is plugging it in. When you plug this thing in, it turns on and you see kind of a red light on the back of the FPV camera. On this one you can change the channels with the button if you wanted to on the side, but I think I'm tuned to the right channel now. And with these Amway Commander goggles, you're just plugging in, you're hearing the beep, and they're ready to go. I'm already tuned to the right channel, so I don't have to do anything except start recording. So let's go slap these on and have some FPV fun. Until that record icon starts flashing on the screen, and we're ready to go. So let's see if I can figure out, remember where the start was on this tank. So I'm pushing the start key. All right, we are ready to go. So you can see the FPV camera there mounted on the barrel. It's perfect where it is. And what's cool about this too, where I have it mounted, is when I pull the barrel down, you see how I can see the front of the tank? So that way I can kind of center my barrel. You see the two fenders there? If I get it right in between the two fenders, then I know I'm centered for forward straight driving. So what we'll do is we'll kind of go over this wood in FPV mode. I want to get the barrel up so it doesn't hit any wood. And let's go ahead and try how it is, see how it is in FPV going over these pieces of wood. I'm just gonna go kind of slow. You can see how it's, you know, it's a little bit jittery, but it's making it over them. Kind of went slow over that one. I don't think I'm gonna attempt this one, so I'll just go ahead and turn on that one. But you can see how simple that was. Pretty darn simple. Let's go ahead and turn the barrel and just see what we did. There we go. So that's our FPV. You can see that we're on top of the barrel. That's all the way left extension. That's where we came from. There I am sitting in the chair. Hello. And again, we want to center our barrel to the front of the tank. So there's our fenders in the front. And I just want to make sure I'm right about there, I think, and that should be centered. I'm just pushing straight forward on the stick, and there we go. So let me drive around the yard here real quick, and that sound is so awesome. So I'm just going to drive around in the grass so you can kind of get a feel of this thing. Let's go into a little bit of dirt here. Cool. So kind of side in some dirt and branches. Now this thing's really good. I mean, as long as the grass isn't super long, this grass hasn't been mowed in about 2 weeks. And it seems to be doing just fine. So I'm like all the way across the yard here. Again, if you're going to turn with this one, try to do like sweeping turns, you know. There we go. Going good. Awesome. So I'm just going to traverse around the yard here, show you how it is. I'm full throttle forward. there's going to be a couple of transitions here when we go onto this sidewalk. There we go. So we're on the sidewalk. I want to hit a couple of these holes I filled a little while ago and see how it does in these ones. These are the holes I did an excavator review in, and I kind of filled them up. But yeah, no problem getting through. That was, you know, a few inches of an edge there. So let's just go ahead and go around to the front of the house here, and I'm going to try to go out in the street while I stay here. You can see me sitting here in the yard. Bye-bye. There it goes, driving past us. You can probably hear it. We'll go ahead and go through the trampoline. This has a good, like, metal bar transition. We can go ahead and easily get over these metal bars on the trampoline. It's like no problem for it. You can see that. Oh, you know what I forgot to do? I set up a little target over here. Let's do that real quick. We're gonna go back over here, turn left, and I set up this foam target right there. You see that? This is gonna be awesome. It's just a couple of pieces of packaging foam that I went ahead and stacked up on a table. Let's see if we can go ahead and hit them. As you can see, the barrel can't go super high, so I'm gonna have to back up a little bit to kind of get proper orientation. And then, of course, we can fine tune our barrel by just moving the barrel left and right. Let's see if we can possibly knock it down. I'm not sure. Here we go, firing. I heard it hit. Oh, that went right through it. Let's try to go back a little bit so I can get a little bit of a better angle. Oh, that's as high as I can make the barrel. Okay. I'm going to have to kind of go on the edge of this sidewalk to... Oh, so I can't seem to really knock this thing down. We go down a little bit more with the barrel. Try a couple more times. Nope. So, as you can see, not a whole lot of power on this airsoft cannon. It is cool, but it's only going to give you maybe like around 100 FPS. Just try a couple more times. Nope, I can't knock that down. Anyway, it does work pretty cool, but just keep that in mind. It's not super powerful. So I want to recenter my, there we go. I want to recenter my cannon right about there. Let's go ahead and shoot the pool one time so you can kind of see, you know, what the shot looks like coming out. Let's raise the cannon and fire. There you go. Can you see that BB coming out? Just a yellow BB. So that's why I put the camera right on the barrel, so I have a little bit of an easier time, you know, kind of aiming. All right, let's just floor it out of here. Let's see if we can get out to the street. I want to make sure my cannon's centered so I know I'm driving straight. There we go. All right, here we go. Let's see if we can hit this transition. Let's see if we can get up this. Oh yeah, out of the yard. We're gonna go into the street or down by the sidewalk. See what we can do. Okay, so I'm turning my head to the left. I'm just trying to kind of face it now. And you can see we're getting a little bit of a breakup. This is only like a 25 milliwatt transmitter, but I'm still in control. You can see me moving the cannon around. Let's go ahead and see if you guys can see how far I am now. So I'm way back there by that big tree back in the backyard. So pretty good range. This is the stock transmitter. Let's go ahead and drive around the sidewalk here for a bit. See if we can find my kid and scare them with a tank. Okay, so I'm kind of like behind the house now, going up some gravel, and you can see that we're kind of getting, you know, a little bit choppy
on the FPV. So I'm just kind of turning my head to kind of bring it back. But yeah, there we are. Still in full control. Let me go ahead and shoot the door real quick. Angle up the cannon a little bit. Let me go shoot the door one more time. Yeah, boom. Boom. Okay, turning around. And let's go ahead and head back down to the street. Here we go, through the grass. I don't want to really go over any curbs, like hardcore curbs, so I want to kind of stay, you know, on the main driveway slope portion. Cool, but I'm in the street here. Kind of back in a little bit of a line of sight for these FPV goggles to be a little better. Let me go ahead and go over to the neighbor's driveway. They've got a little bit of a lip on their driveway here, and see if we can get over it. There we go. Oh, we're kind of high centered on the middle. Let me get down. Hopefully the tank tracks aren't going to come off. No cars are going to run us over. Let's try it straight on. Get over this. Oh yeah, okay. Got over it. Now we're in our neighbor's driveway. This is great, man. I didn't think it would reach this far on stock controller, but it seems like it's doing fine. Whoa, got over that. Here we are on the side of their house. Oh, you know what I forgot to do? Let's see if we can get up this hill. This hill is a little bit steep. Let's see how this thing does. You can see how the FPV camera is getting a little dark, or it's a little dark here. Woo! Well, that was cool. And we're A-OK. Let me go ahead and get over here to, we've got this little landscaping strip. I want to see if I can get over it. The video might start to get a little bit scratchy, but let's just try it. So far, so good. Coming over here by the cars. You can see the FPV is starting to get kind of messed up. That's because I'm like directly behind the house now with this FPV, so it's getting a little scratchy. But let's see if we can get over this. Full throttle. Oh yeah. Wow, we got over it into the planter area with this pretty thick gravel. See if we can get out of it. I'm gonna back out of it. Nope. Whoa. Uh-oh. Okay, we gotta hit it at an angle again. Go! Oh. Hope I'm not ruining the tracks. Let's go forward and then to the left. Go! Oh, shoot. Okay. I'm gonna have to go check it for it pretty soon, but let's just try one more time. At an angle. Oh man, we're like almost there. Shucks. Okay, I'm just gonna go full reverse now. Let's see if we can possibly get out reverse. Oh yeah. Yeah, we're out. Okay, tracks are still good. Apparently. Full throttle forward into the sun. Sorry about that. Let's go down here a little bit on this edge of the sidewalk. Go around this electrical box. I can't believe I still have like full good control. So it's working out really good. I'm gonna go ahead and come on back. I think we did, you know, really good with all of our testing, and this thing did really well. Let's just go right around this tree. Let's do one last thing. Try not to fall off the edge and go around this tree. Wow, I'm really surprised at what this thing can do. It's doing really well. Full throttle forward now. It feels like the cannon might be a little off, so let me go ahead and yeah, it is a little bit off. So it was to a little bit to the left, so I'm going to go to the right. I'm looking at my fenders, and I'm going to go straight forward. This one seems to pull a little to the left, so I've got to give it a little bit of a right turn every once in a while input. Oh, I just rammed the cement, but I made it over. Awesome. So since this thing is super light on the FPS, I wouldn't try this at home, but you know what, guys? I'm going to try to shoot myself and just see how sore it is and see if I can hit myself. I do have FPV goggles on, so I won't be hitting my eyeballs. Let's just try it. Okay, I felt it hit the chair. That's as high up as I can go. Okay, this is gonna like hit my arm. Oh, okay, I hit my leg right here. But it really wasn't sore at all. Nowhere near as powerful as like a airsoft gun. Yeah, it's just barely hitting me in the shorts, and I just feel a little tap. So nothing major at all. Again, don't do this at home, you know. I'm a reviewer, and we do stupid things like this just to show you guys how these things work. Let's try one more time. Get up here. Let me go back a little bit so we have a little bit more range. That may be a slight con with these tanks is you don't have much lift on the barrel. Let's try again. Firing now. Oh, missed myself on that one again. Keep hitting the chair. Now I'm going to hit my knee. Yep, so you hit my like pants right here, and it's not sore at all. It barely has anything, maybe even less than 100 FPS, so you're not going to really hurt anybody with this thing. Okay, that hit my hand right here, and it really, nothing, not even sore. Awesome. So as you can see, this thing is a blast to drive around. Let's go ahead and shut this thing down. Get over here. Let me get everything lined up again. And shut this thing down pretty soon. Maybe do a little bit more hardcore driving here and just really try to get over some stuff. I can't quite get over this log, but it sure is fun. Maybe we can shoot it out of the way. Nope, can't reach down enough to shoot it. All right, cool. So let's go ahead and shut this bad boy down and go ahead and do like a pros and cons on it. All right,
let's go ahead and shut her down. That's it. So it sounds so cool. The sound effects are really awesome on this one. But that's about it, guys. So let's go ahead and go through a quick little pros and cons on the Henglong German Tiger 1 tank and see how this thing did. So I think for the price, I mean, this thing's right around $100, I think. And I think for the price, this thing's awesome. Like I said on the table, is you can get some metal tank tracks for this one. You can get metal drive wheels and also metal gears inside, so it has a lot more power, and you can also upgrade the motors inside of it so you can give it a lot more power. I noticed that some of the pieces, like this side over here, kind of fell off. This side here was supposed to have another piece, and it did, but it fell off somewhere in the yard. So maybe try to super glue on the pieces that were loose. Like one of these lights was a little loose, so I went ahead and super glued that in. And then this is the gunner stick here for shooting. I'm not sure if I showed you guys that yet with the stick in, but when the gun barrel's in there and you shoot, it has a pretty neat effect where you see the flash of the red there coming out the front of the gun, but the sides painted black. So it looks pretty cool for the machine gun effect. Let's shut it down. And the sound, speaking of, the sound is awesome. That's a total pro with this one. They got really good sound effects. The attention to detail is pretty darn good for a cheap tank like this, and all those extra little accessories, you know, shovels, tools, cables, you know, tow cables, all this kind of stuff is really neat. I was really satisfied with that part of it. It seemed like the range was pretty far, you know. That had to have been like at least 200 feet. And then even behind the house directly that way, this little camera did pretty good. You know, I was getting some breakup when I was all the way across the house going through all the walls and all that stuff. But overall, it did very good. As far as the climbing abilities, you know, good for what it is. Go through grass fine, dirt fine, gravel. I did some gravel over there in the front.
These logs, it couldn't really get over that tall log over there, but it did, you know, very reasonably for the type of plastic tracks it has. I think you can get some kind of rubberized tracks for this one as well, where it has a little bit of rubber, and so you have a little bit more grip. It did great in climbing some, you know, hill transitions over there near the neighbor's yard over there. It did great on that little, you know, potter plant yard median thing. That thing was pretty high, and it was able to climb over that at certain angles. And the tank tracks didn't come off this time. When I did a little run earlier and tried to just turn, you know, just a straight turn in the grass, this thing turns pretty quick. I guess it was a little bit too much for it, and one of these tracks came off. And so I just had to put it back on. Really easy, you just, you know, look at the other track, how it's on, and then just keep rotating it and pushing it on. What I'm noticing right now is that little mud flap came off on this side of the back, so I'm gonna have to go and look for that. These things just kind of go in by, they're kind of like push and push up. So you push them in and then you push up and they kind of lock in. But it's probably from going over some of that big stuff. It's probably either over here or out towards the front of the house. So I'll have to go and find that. Maybe kind of glue those in or do something where they won't pull out, because they are kind of loose and just shaking in there. As you can see, the barrel and the top of the tank turned really well. It has a really good degree of almost 360 degrees of a turn. The barrel kind of limited, you know, it's not very much of a degree of tilt, maybe like 10 degrees total, you know, 10 to 15 degrees. So you're going to have to really angle yourself good for shots. You don't have much of an arc to shoot. And then that gets us to the airsoft power. The airsoft power wasn't much at all. You know, you could be like, I was shooting myself from just, you know, maybe about 15 feet away, and I could barely feel it, just a little tap on my leg. So the airsoft power is not big on this thing, but it's just the cool factor that this thing can shoot airsofts remotely is definitely awesome. And the runtime, I did a runtime test on this thing in the house, and I was getting like 30 minutes of constant driving, so it's going to have plenty of drive time to have fun. I think for the money, it's a really good fun tank. Anybody that gets this is going to love it. You know, as long as you're not like crashing it down things and hitting cement and cracking on cement. You know, this is hard plastic and it could be kind of brittle if you started smashing it downstairs and stuff. So just be careful. If somebody's going to own it, you know, don't go driving off curbs onto concrete or asphalt, because you'll probably break something. Otherwise, a great tank. Really, really satisfied with it. And I hope you guys enjoyed that review. I'll go ahead and have the peripherals I have here, the tank, in the description, plus the FPV camera in there, so you can go ahead and check that out. And if you're interested in, you know, trying out some FPV goggles, those Amway Commander V1 goggles are really awesome. I'm really loving them. Those are my go-to goggles right now, because they have that scan feature, 40 channels, DVR built in, and they seem to be performing really well, even better than my Fat Sharks. So, oh, there's another little thing. You see this little tow hitch kind of got pushed up, so I'm just sliding it back in there. So if you are driving around and kind of bashing like I did, certain things might be falling off around the wheel, so make sure those things are either in good or glued in, you know, like that mud flap and stuff. Anyway, guys, hope you liked the review, and I'll see you in the next one. This one was fun for me, and I'm going to be doing more like this, so stay tuned and subscribe to the channel for some more awesome videos like this. Anyway, thanks for watching.